childrens, how are you all? I hope you are fine and safe. As in previous videos, in part 4, we have finished question number 1st of exercise 1st B, and some homework also I gave you for doing. Hope that will be done properly by you. And now today we are going to start question number 2 of exercise 1st B. As you can see here, question number 2, it is given 14 upon 5 and 72 upon 10 into mixed fraction. So how can we convert it and B part into improper fraction, and 3 upon 5, 4 upon 7 into like fraction, and D part 29 upon 1000, 9 in whole, 7 upon 10 into decimal fraction. As you done this question into previous class 4th also. But now, how to solve it? I will tell you. Let's see the solution of this question. See carefully. Here see question number 2. Change 14 upon 5 and 72 upon 10 into mixed fraction. That question was only. So here written 14 upon 5 simply. Okay, we will divide denominator by numerator. 5 by 14, how many times divisible? 5 to the 10. What is coming here? 10 only. Okay, then 14 minus 10, how much left here? 4. And 5 by 4 not divisible, so this is left only carry. Now we will write this fraction into mixed fraction. Okay, formula of this 14 upon 5, write as it is equal to, for converting proper fraction into mixed fraction, it is cosine in whole remainder upon divisor. Okay, so here cosine what is coming? 2. Okay, write cosine in whole means as integral part. 2 in whole and remainder what is coming? 4. 4 as numerator means upside, and downside what is? Divisor. What is divisor? Is 5 only. Okay, so 14 upon 5 can be convert into mixed fraction like this. 2 in whole, 4 upon 5. Clear? Similarly next part also. Okay, I am writing the solution of this. 14 upon 5 answer what was coming? Remainder upside what was coming? That is 4. And cosine 2 upon 5. Okay. Next 72 upon 10. Divide denominator by numerator. 10 by 72. It will be divisible. 7 times 10, 7 to 70. What is left? 2 minus 0. 2 only. Remainder is coming 2, cosine is 7. Okay, again write this fraction and convert into mixed fraction. So cosine it will be at in as integral part, 7 in whole and remainder as numerator upside, and downside what will be? Divisor, that is 10. So required fraction what will be? 7 in whole, 2 upon 10. And 14 upon 5 can be written 2 in whole, 4 upon 5. Okay, we call it integral part, and this one part it is called fractional part. And here 7 is integral part and 2 upon 10 it is fractional part. Okay, now next question number, which one? Second B part. Okay, B part is given 5 in whole, 3 upon 8 and 6 in whole, 3 upon 11 into improper fraction. Okay, these are mixed fraction and converting into improper fraction. So how to convert? It is given 5 in whole, 3 upon 8. Simply do multiply denominator by integral part. Means whole number. Okay, 8 5 is 40 and plus numerator, 40 plus 3. What will be 40 plus 3? And downside, as it is right, denominator. Okay. Again, I am telling 8 fives means denominator multiply by whole number means integral part. 8 fives are 40 plus numerator. Numerator what is? 3. 40 plus 3, 43 upon 8. Okay, it is your required improper fraction. Now next, 6 whole 3 upon 11. Similarly, we can do like this. Okay, 11 means denominator multiply by whole number. So 11 6 are 66 plus and numerator what is 3 upon 11 as it is right, means denominator as it is right. 66 plus 3 what will be 69 upon 11. Got it? Again 6 in whole 3 upon 11. Simply do multiply which number? Denominator by whole number, otherwise integral part. Integral part here is given 6, no? So 11 multiply by 6. 11 6 are 66 plus numerator. Numerator is given 3. 66 plus 3 upon 11 is equal to what will be 69 upon 11. Got it? Next question is C part. Here is 3 upon 5 and 4 upon 7 into like fraction. Okay. So here we will convert 3 upon 5 and 4 upon 7 into like fraction. How to convert? Simply, what will be here? First fraction what is given? 3 upon 5. And second fraction what is given? 4 upon 7. Okay. Second fraction, denominator 7. Multiply by 7, upside and downside. Okay, in first fraction. And in second fraction, multiply by 5 in second fraction. Okay, only do cross multiply, but by denominator only. So here we will do multiply by 7 and upside also 7, means as numerator or denominator. And second fraction 4 upon 7, here is given. First fraction denominator what is given? 5. So do multiply by 5 as numerator and denominator. Okay, upside and downside both. Now after doing multiply here, 3 7 ja 21 and 5 7 ja 35. Here 4 5 ja 20 and 7 5 ja 35. Here you can see 35 denominator and here also denominator 35. Both are coming. So like fraction, those are which having same denominator. So here 21 upon 35 and 20 upon 35. Both are like fraction because both having same denominator. Okay. Similarly, you can do other part also. Okay. Next, see question number. Here is second D part. This is also from your book. Here is 29 upon 1000 and 9 in whole 7 upon 2 into decimal numbers. How to convert? Here is given 29 upon 1000. Okay. Simply we can find this. Directly we can do here. Here how many 0? 1, 2, 3. Okay. 3 0 are given. So point means as numerator, right upside number only, simply 29. 3 0 are given. 1, 2, 3. 3 0 only given. So point will be after how many digit? 3 digit. Okay. Otherwise we call it upon 1000. 1 upon 1000 we call it what? Thousands. That will be equal 1 upon 1000. Okay. Simply we can put after 3 digit only. So 1, 2, 3 digit. So put the point after 3 digit. And from right to left side. Count here. 1, 2, third digit not given. So take here 0 by yourself and put the point. Okay. So required answer part will be 0.029. Similarly, next part, 9 in whole 7 upon 10. Okay. So firstly, we will convert this fraction into proper fraction. So here 10 9 ja 90 and plus numerator 7. 90 plus 7, 97 upon 10. And outside 10 only, as denominator 10, so point will be after one digit only. So 97 and after one digit, point is here. Okay, so required answer what will be 9.7, and this one answer what will be 29 upon 1000 0.029. Clear? Then after, see the question number third. Here see question number 3, it is given. But before this, question number 2, as I told you, A, B, C and D part, practice of this question properly. Okay, now let us see the question number 3. What is given? Fill in with greater or equal sign. So how can we solve it? Okay, see this question number 3rd A part. I will solve here. Third A part, here is given 2 upon 7 and here is 5 upon 7. Okay. Simply do cross multiply only. Okay. This one, here numerator what is given? 2 and here is 5. So 2 multiply by 7 and here 5 multiply by 7 only. Okay. Again I am telling 2 multiply by 7 and here is numerator 5 multiply by this denominator 7. Simply do cross multiply only. Here 2 7 is 14 and here 5 7 is 35. Which is coming greater? 35 is greater by 14. Okay, so fraction which one will be greater? 5 upon 7. So make sign right side. Similarly, B part also. Here is given 6 upon 13 and 6 upon 17. 6 multiply by 17. Do this. 6 multiply 17. And here is 6 multiply by 13. 17 6 is 102. Otherwise you can check, simply multiply on rough page also. And 13 6 is how much? 78. Which is coming more? 102. It is more. So fraction which one will be greater? Left side. So make sign left side. Clear? Similarly, you can do C, D and E part also. Now we will see question number 4, A part. Here also make the sign which is greater and which is equal. Okay. Now see, fourth A part, here is given 0.5 and here is 0.50. Okay, before point 0 is given and before point 0 is given. Ones place 0 and 0. Now after point, what is given? 10th place is 5 and here 10th place is 5. Both are coming equal. Got it? And here is given 0 more. You are thinking 50, it is greater? No. After point, those are 0. We can let this. So here 0.5 and 0.5 both are equal. So make the sign equal. Okay. Next part B. Here is 2.06. Here is 2.006. Here see. After point, in lasting not given any zero. So simply check here. Firstly, before point here is ones place, what is given? 2. Here is also 2. Both are equal. Now after point, check here, 10th place is given 0 and here 10th place is given 0. Now hundredth place is given 6, and here 100th place what is given? 0. So 6 is greater by 0. 6 is greater by 0, no? Because here 100th place is given 6 and here is given 0. Which is less? So 6 is greater, so make the sign left side. 2.06 is greater by 2.006. Got it? Similarly, you can do other remaining part also. Okay, C and D part. Now let us see question number 5. What is given? Arrange in descending order. Descending order means biggest, means bigger number to smaller number. Okay. So here we will check question, what is given? See this. It is given. How can we do it? You can see it is 5 upon 11, 7 upon 11, 8 upon 11, 3 upon 11, and 10 upon 11. You can see here all fraction denominator is 11. It means all are like fraction. These fraction are like fraction because all having same denominator. So we can check simply upside number only. Okay. So arrange the upside number into descending order. Descending order means bigger number to smaller number. So here, which is the bigger number in these? 10 only. So first fraction what will be? 10 upon 11. Left this. Now in these number, which is the bigger number? 8. So second fraction what will be? 8 upon 11. Then after, left this, 5, 7, 3. In these, which is the bigger? 7. So next fraction what will be? 7 upon 11. Then after, 5 and 3. 5 is bigger. Then write 5 upon 11, comma. Last, which one left? 3 upon 11. Okay. So descending order of this fraction what will be? 10 upon 11, 8 upon 11, 7 upon 11, 5 upon 11, and 3 upon 11. Got it? Similarly, you can do B part also. Okay? Here is given B part. Here also given fraction. Okay? And I am telling you how you will do this question. Here numerator is given. Same. It is also. So simply you will find descending order. So what will be? Which one having a smaller denominator? That one will be greatest fraction. Okay. So first number will be 4 upon 7. Then after 4 upon 9. Okay. 1, 2. Then after 4 upon 11. Third number will be. And then after 4 upon 15. Fourth one, this one, and last left 4 upon 70. Got it? Next question number. What it is given? Question number 6. Arrange in ascending order. Okay? It is opposite of descending order. Ascending order means smaller number to bigger number. Okay? So here 6A part, what is given? Just see here. 0.101, 0.110, 0.102, and 1.021. Okay? So firstly we will check which is the smaller number because we are arranging into ascending order, smaller to bigger number. Okay, so let us see. Here is given before point 0 is given. Here before point, here also 0. Okay, we can take 0 also, 0 point. here also we can take 0. Okay, here before point ones place 0, before point ones place 0, and before point ones place is 0, but here is 1 and 1, so these are greater number. So let these firstly check only smaller number. Now after point 10th place is 1, here 10th place is 1, here also 1. 100th place is 0, here 100th place is 1, and here 100th place is 0. So it is also bigger because here 100th place is given 1. So check only in these two number. Here thousands place is 1 and here is 2. Okay, so here in 1 and 2, 2 is bigger, so it is also bigger. So which is the smaller number? Firstly smaller number will be which one? 0.101. Now in these, which is the smaller? In these point after 10th place 1, here 1, 100th 1, here 0. 0 is less, the second number this one will be. Now after that, third one, this one. Now lastly, in these check, before point 1, okay, and here is 1, 10th place 0, 10th place 0. 100th place 2 and 100th place also 2, and thousands place here not given, here maybe 0 and here is 1, so 0 is less than, so after that which one will be smaller number? 4, this one, and last this one. Okay, now arrange these number into ascending order. Which one is coming smaller number? Here is coming 0.101, then after 0.110, sorry, not this, this is coming second number 102. Okay, this one will be 0.102, then after 0.110, and then after fourth number 1.02, and last one 1.021. okay, again I am writing first one, which one? 0.101, second 0.102, third one 0.110, and next what was? 1.02, and last this one. Okay, so you can arrange first number 0.101, then after which one is bigger? 0.102, then after third one 0.110, then after fourth one 1.02, and last one is coming 1.021. okay, this is your required answer. Got it? Similarly, you can do B part also. Okay? So, till for today, this is only, and tomorrow means in next video, part 6, we will start question number 7. Okay? And 8 also. That will be tomorrow. And one more thing, which are remaining part, as you can see here, yes, third CDE, fourth CDE, and fifth B part, sixth B part, these are remaining part, that will be your homework. I will give this question as homework. Got it? So till for today, this is enough only from me. Thank you, students. Have a nice day.